appreciate it.
We're here every Saturday.
Well, I'm just passing by. I'm at it, you know. I'm on leave, so.
Okay, what, you in the military?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, we were just
I'm headed to Iraq, so.
Oh man.
It's a valley of Jehoshaphat, man. Where they're going to make you fight against the Lord.
I'll go AWOL if I was you.
I did read that in Revelation.
Yes, we was bringing it up. They gonna, do you got a chip or anything like that?
Hey, get the script, bro. Get the script.
Remember what I was talking about?
Hey, man.
You get that chip, you are gonna die.
Get the script.
Hey, bro, let me tell you something real quick, bro.
That's it, right there.
Bro, let me tell you something right now. Hey, the Lord brought you right here to either deliver you or condemn you. That's the reason why you're here.
I knew about it. They were talking about it.
I'm a conscientious objector. What's on your wallet? Chip?
Oh,
shit. Actually, I already gave you your own chip.
Yeah. But the Lord, if you get the you.
Have you actually got the little.
It's on an ID.
Oh,
it is the RFID chip.
Right.
But, like, you know, like, it does go on.
You know what? We had a guy that came up to the other side a couple weeks ago. He had a couple chips inside of him already.
Wow. He was in the military too.
That dude's gonna die, man.
Yeah, but
no way out.
I don't know. You serve your country, you know.
No, not over the country.
Hey, this country's gonna die. This is Babylon the Great.
Yeah.
America's Babylon the Great, man.
They stole
all this, everything they doing, setting up space, these satellites, creating all these weapons, are to go to war with the Lord, man.
Yeah.
The so-called white man knows that the Lord has come. That's why Ronald Reagan said, if we had a universal enemy come from space, will we not all get together and fight?
So you guys do not support, like, the military?
Hell no. First of all, fuck this country, bro. They fucking murdered us. They murdered our brothers. How the fuck are you gonna serve a country that killed their people?
The Zoot Suits. The Zoot Suits, man. The Navy came to that right here.
Right here.
They were raping our fucking women, Mexican women. They were killing our men, man. Nobody did shit.
Hey, that's it. Get that.
There still has been no justice.
This dude
was
in the army. There you go. Brother of the tribe of.
You call that a fellow brother, man? Fuck these crackers, man.
Right.
The so called white man is going to be destroyed, man. Right. So if you want to not be destroyed, conscientious objective, man.
Hey, bro,
thank you guys so much.
We got to redo your consequence for taking this.
Revelations 13 and 16. And he calls it all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in their right hand.
When you're in their military, you're bond. You're a prisoner, you're a slave, man.
Galvanized iron.
Go ahead, say it again.
Galvanized iron.
Do you have the definition for that?
With galvanized iron, that's the GI, right? That's basically saying that you're a slave. Because you're ironed up, you know?
And I think, who said that? Was it Kissinger or...
Henry Kissinger said that all army men are nothing but useless pawns
dumb dogs
for our agendas.
That's one of your heads, man.
To receive a mark in their right hand or in their forehead.
In your brain or in your neck, anywhere in your head.
The dude over there, he had one under his tongue, big one in his arm. He had like four chips that they had on.
He's done. The Lord gonna kill that man.
And that no man may might buy or sell.
Like we was telling you, they're gonna collapse this economy, and that's gonna be the new money. You're already gonna have it if you get it, man. Go ahead.
And that no man might buy or sell, save he that had the mark.
Save he that got the mark. And the word right there for mark is blood, meaning an incision. Because the way they put that inside you is through incision, through an injection. You know, and now read the consequence on 14. Man.
Okay, Revelations 14 and 9. And the third angel followed them, saying with a loud voice, if any man worship the beast and his image.
The beast is America, NATO, and the European Union, the entire empire of the so-called white man.
If any man worship the beast and his image and receive his mark in his forehead or in his hand, the same shall drink of the wine of the wrath of the Most High, which is poured out without mixture.
Get the message, man. This is going to be the end of the United States, man. According to 200 million of these are going to hit this place, man. And then when the Lord shows up in the Valley of Jehoshaphat over there in the Persian Gulf, as it is written, he's going to burn you up with a chariot, man, which is what they call the Holy Ghost, man. It tells you in the scriptures that all that's gonna be left of the military is dust and the smell of smoke. That's it. You're gonna be evaporated in an instant, man. Bueno?
The same shall drink of the wine of the wrath of the Most High, which is powered out without mixture into the cup of his indignation. He shall be tormented with fire and brimstone.
There you go. That's your turn. You get that shit, you ain't gonna make it, man. And when you come back in the kingdom of heaven, you're gonna be with your fucking head down when you see the Lord. You ain't gonna be happy. You ain't gonna be excited like, Lord willing, we gonna be, man. You know? Excited because we didn't get the chip. We did what the Lord said, man. Yeah. So now the Lord brought you here. You got a choice, man. When you hit that milk, when you go back, you get that chip. You know, or they present you with the chip again. That the Lord is presenting you with your last chance. You get the chip, you're going to die.
Man, I would say, fuck that. Go get a forklift license and go do a regular Joe Schmo 9-to-5, man.
Hey, thank you guys so much.
Hey, Con,
That's multiple people.
That's
coming, talking about he about to get the chip, man.
Hey.
He about to get the chip.
Hey, the time is nine, man.
What? Be here, man.
Hey, yo, time is playing, man.
Be hey, here.
And right now, the heaviest prophecy that's being pushed right now for the spirit of y'all about to be that chip.
Yeah.
Why? Because it's coming, and it's coming down to the wire. Right. We're all three witnesses.
Yeah.
That's y'all about to be outside all day.
Yeah, man. And. That's why he said that you don't want to be on camera because they threaten you, man.
Yeah.
They like I brought out on the live show when I swore in, they made me watch a video of a dude hanging and another dude was blindfolded and he got shot in the back of the head, man. Then they turned on the light and said, "This is your last chance to leave." You know, if you stay, that means you win. You're swearing in. But if you want to back, if that scares you, leave. You know what I'm saying? So that's why they threatened him, man. You know what I'm saying?
Hey, man. If Jake is watching it, you Israelites, you Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, and Seminole Indians, you thinking of joining the army like that, dude? He already telling you, you know, that they chipping him. He's like, that's the next step right there. Before he goes to Iraq, man. So, hey, man, now's the time, like I said, I'll go AWOL, man. Or fucking, I don't know, man. It's time to fucking, get your cousins, get your crackhead cousins pissed.
Yeah.
And fucking pour that shit up in the thing so they can fucking kick your ass out or something.
Yeah.
You know, hey, because I knew a dude that did that. You wanted it out. Yeah, man. I got some dirty piss and got kicked out, man. But, yeah, man. Hey, man, it ain't no time for no joke, man. This ain't no joke, man. It's time to, you know, take heed to the scripture, man. You know, it ain't what we saying, it's what the scripture's saying, man. And we already read the judgment to anybody that takes the chip. You can't take it and then take it out, man. You know? So with that, you know, brothers got any scripture, man?